गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्लास 11th, सब्जेक्ट केमिस्ट्री, चैप्टर 6, थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, एंड दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 6. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एंथैल्पी ऑफ सॉल्यूशन, बोर्न-हैबर साइकिल, स्पॉन्टेनियस एंड नॉन स्पॉन्टेनियस रिएक्शंस, एंट्रोपी एंड एंट्रोपी एज अ स्टेट फंक्शन. सो वी विल बिगिन विद एंथैल्पी ऑफ सॉल्यूशन. सपोज देयर इज अ सॉल्वेंट. An energy of this solvent is U1. When we dissolve a substance in this solvent, then what will happen? After dissolution, energy of the system will change. Now, the energy of the solution is U2. So, this change in energy is known as enthalpy of solution. Okay? Or enthalpy change of the solution. So, here we will define enthalpy of solution. The enthalpy change when one mole of the substance dissolve in a specified amount of the solvent. So here the substance which we are dissolving in the solvent is 1 mole. Okay, so amount of the substance is fixed. So when 1 mole of the substance is dissolved in the solvent, the change in energy is known as enthalpy of solution. Now there is a point, if large volume of the solvent is taken, that further addition of the solvent does not produce any more heat change, and it is called enthalpy of solution at infinite solution. A solvent is in excess amount, okay, and solute is present in very, very small amount, then there will be no change in the energy, and at that stage we will say that this is enthalpy of infinite dilution. Now we will do calculation of enthalpy of solution. We want to determine value of enthalpy of solution. So, enthalpy of solution is determined from the lattice enthalpy and enthalpy of hydration. You are already familiar with the term lattice enthalpy from third chapter. What is lattice enthalpy? So, lattice enthalpy is when 1 mole of the ionic compound dissociate into ions in the gaseous state. For example, when NaCl dissociate into Na positive and Cl negative ion, and these ions are in gaseous state, then the energy required is known as lattice enthalpy. Okay, there is one more enthalpy which we need for the calculation of enthalpy of solution, and that is enthalpy of hydration. So when these ions interact with water, then the amount of energy released is known as enthalpy of hydration. You are already familiar with this term also from the previous lecture. So in the first step, there will be dissociation of the ionic solid, which is solute, into free ions. So let us take example of NaCl salt. When we dissolve NaCl in water, then first step will be dissociation of NaCl into free ions. Okay, that means Na positive and Cl negative ions. And for this process, the energy required is known as lattice energy or lattice enthalpy. Step 2 is hydration of the ions. Okay, now these gaseous ions, they will interact with solvent. Then the energy released in this process is known as hydration energy. Okay, here we will use the term solvation when solvent is other than water. But when solvent is water, then we will use the term hydration. Okay, so these are the two steps. So from these two steps, we will find out energy, lattice energy and hydration energy. Then we will add these two and we will get enthalpy of solution. Okay, so this is change in enthalpy of solution is equal to change in lattice enthalpy plus change in hydration enthalpy. So that means we need these two energy for the change in enthalpy of solution. So first we will find out lattice enthalpy. So calculation of lattice enthalpy from Born-Haber cycle. What is Born-Haber cycle? Okay, so Born and Haber in 1919 put forward a method, and in this method, here you can see the diagram that this is Na sodium atom in solid state and this is half of fluorine molecule. Okay, and both combines with each other and forms NaCl compound. Okay, 1 mole of NaCl compound. As you can see here, in this reaction, there is formation of 1 mole of NaCl compound So the amount of energy released is known as enthalpy of formation. So this is delta F H naught. F stands for enthalpy of formation. Okay. Now how this compound is formed? So this is the mechanism of the reaction. Okay. So first, sodium atom will convert into gaseous state. Okay. So when solid state converts into gaseous state, then sublimation energy will be there. So this S sign is for sublimation energy. After that, this gaseous atom, this gaseous sodium atom will convert into a cation. Okay, sodium positive gaseous cation. Okay, so when a gaseous atom converts into cation, which is in gaseous state, then which energy will involve? The energy is known as ionization energy. Okay, so when sodium convert into sodium positive gaseous ion, then this is ionization energy. In the same way, half of Cl2 molecule first convert into atom. Okay, this is molecule, right? And this is half mole of Cl2. So here, first Cl2 molecule will convert into Cl atom, chlorine atom, which is in gaseous state. Okay, so when a molecule converts into atom, then which energy will involve? This is bond dissociation enthalpy, or we can say atomization energy, because this is diatomic molecule. And for diatomic molecule, bond dissociation enthalpy and atomization enthalpy are same. So here we will multiply bond dissociation enthalpy with half, because this is half mole of Cl2 molecule. So this is half of bond dissociation enthalpy, which is represented by capital D. Okay. So first we will convert Cl2 molecule into gaseous atom. After that, this atom will convert into an anion. Okay. Cl will convert into Cl negative ion, which is in gaseous state. So which energy will involve here? This is electron gain enthalpy. Because as you can see here, that this chlorine atom has no charge, but here there is one extra electron. That means there is addition of electron in a gaseous atom. Okay, so that means this is electron gain enthalpy. Okay, electron gain enthalpy is also known as electron affinity. So it is represented by capital E dot capital A. Now what will happen? Now these two ions will combine with each other and they will form NaCl compound. Okay, so this energy is lattice energy. Okay, because according to definition of lattice energy, one mole of the ionic compound dissociate into ions in the gaseous state, or we can say one mole of the ionic compound forms from the ions in the gaseous state. Okay, so here sodium positive ion will combine with Cl negative ion and it will form NaCl compound. Okay, so this U stand for lattice enthalpy. And when these two ions combines with each other, then energy will release. That is why we have written here negative sign. Okay. Now we will write equation for these steps. Okay. So here, first is when sodium atom combines with half mole of Cl2 molecule and forms NaCl compound, that means this reaction. Okay. So for this reaction, enthalpy of formation is, this is standard enthalpy of formation, okay, it is equal to minus 410 kilojoule per mole. Okay, now here first step is crystalline sodium metal is sublimed to form gaseous atom. That means sodium atom will convert from solid state to gaseous state. Okay, so this is sublimation energy, so we will represent it with capital S. Second step is, now Cl2 molecule will convert into chlorine atom. Okay, so this is bond dissociation enthalpy. As you can see here, that this is half mole. So here, half into bond dissociation enthalpy. Now in third step, sodium will convert into ion. That means a cation. Okay, so here sodium will lose one electron and it will acquire positive charge. So this is ionization energy, delta I H. In fourth step, chlorine will accept one electron and it will convert into Cl negative ion. When it will accept one electron, then energy will release. sign will be negative. Okay, and this energy is electron gain enthalpy, which is represented by capital E dot A. In fifth step, Na positive ion will combine with Cl negative ion and it will form a compound NaCl. Okay, so this energy is lattice enthalpy and it is represented by capital U. Now we will add these enthalpy. Okay, so delta F H naught, that means enthalpy of formation. Standard enthalpy of formation is equal to sublimation energy plus half of bond dissociation enthalpy plus ionization enthalpy plus electron gain enthalpy plus lattice enthalpy. Now value of all these energies are known except lattice enthalpy. We want to find out value of lattice enthalpy. Okay, so here we will put the values. Here -410 kilojoule per mole. Here sublimation energy is 104. As you can see here that this is positive sign, that means energy is required to convert solid state into gaseous state. In bond dissociation enthalpy also, this is positive, so that means energy is required to convert a molecule into atom. And this is ionization enthalpy, and in ionization enthalpy also, energy is required to convert a gaseous atom into a cation. Okay, so this is positive. This is electron gain enthalpy. Electron gain enthalpy is negative because when we add electron in a gaseous atom, then energy release. Okay, so that is why this sign is negative. Plus U, that means lattice energy. So U is equal to -788 kilojoule per mole. As you can see here, the sign is negative here. That means when Na positive ion combines with Cl negative ion, then energy release. Okay. Now there are two important consequences of lattice enthalpy which you should keep in your mind. The first is, greater the lattice enthalpy, more stable the ionic compound. That means when two ions combines with each other and they release energy, if amount of energy which is released by combination of ions is more, that means that ionic compound is stable. Okay. Second point is, greater the lattice enthalpy of an ionic compound, less is its solubility in water, because now ionic compound is stable. So dissolution of that ionic compound in water will be less because the compound is already stable. Okay, so that means hydration enthalpy will be less. Its solubility in water will be less. Now we will move to next topic, that is spontaneous and non-spontaneous process. So what is spontaneous process? Spontaneous process, those process which happens by itself. Okay. For example, dissolution of common salt in water. Okay, when we dissolve salt into water, then it dissolves in water by itself, right? Or you can say the flow of waterfall is always in the downward direction, right? So this is also a spontaneous process. We cannot reverse it. Okay, the flow of water in a waterfall will always be in downward direction. Next is, if you keep water in an open vessel in sunlight, then what will happen? There will be evaporation, right? Water will convert into vapors, and this is also a spontaneous reaction because it happens by itself. Next is flow of heat from hot body to cold body. And next example is flow of water down the hill. So all these processes are spontaneous in nature. Okay, so spontaneous process which happens by itself. So in short, we can say that a process which is feasible, that means a process which is possible, is spontaneous process. Now we will talk about non-spontaneous process. A process which can neither take place by itself nor by initiation is called non-spontaneous process. So here we will take example like flow of water up a hill. Water always flow down the hill, right? Its direction cannot be from the down to top. So it is a non-spontaneous reaction. In the same way, heat from a cold body to hot body. Okay, because flow of heat is always from hot body to cold body. And reverse is not possible. Next one, diffusion of gas from low pressure to high pressure. And next one is dissolution of sand into water. So all these processes are non-spontaneous in nature. Now we will move to next topic, that is entropy. What is entropy? Entropy is a measure of randomness or disorder of the system. Okay. So here we will take one example. Suppose there is a system and in which gaseous particles are moving with a very fast speed. Okay. And there is second container in which gaseous molecules are moving with a very slow rate. Then in which container randomness is more? The container which has particles with fast speed has more randomness because their particles are moving with fast speed. Okay. You will understand this with the help of this diagram. In this diagram, there are three states, okay, solid, liquid and gaseous state. In solid state, particles are fixed, right? They are not moving. In gaseous state, particles are moving. And in liquid state, we can say that there is intermediate randomness or intermediate movement of the particles. So here we will say that there is least randomness of the particle. Okay. So that means entropy is the least in this one. Okay. But here in liquid state, particles are moving, right? They can move. So here there is more randomness. So entropy is more. And in gaseous state, particles are free to move. So there is maximum randomness in this one, in this example, right? So maximum randomness means maximum entropy. Okay. So when we are heating it, then what is happening? Then entropy is increasing. Okay. So this is increasing order of entropy or randomness. So entropy is randomness. If randomness is more, that means entropy is more. Entropy is represented by capital S, and for the solid state it has the lowest entropy, for the gaseous state it has highest entropy, and for the liquid state it has entropy in between the two. Entropy is also independent of the path, that means it is also a state function like internal energy and enthalpy. Now delta S means change in entropy. Okay, like there are two systems and we want to find out change in randomness. So here we will write S2 minus S1. The change in the value of entropy is known as entropy change. Now we will study entropy in detail. So entropy as in state function. Okay, so here we will do one derivation where we will take a container, a cylinder which contains a gas. And it is fitted with frictionless and weightless piston and placed in contact with a large heat reservoir. So here you can see the diagram. Suppose this is a container in which a gas is filled and this is a piston. Okay, this piston is weightless and frictionless. Okay, and this system is kept near a heat reservoir. So as the system is kept near the heat reservoir, that means heat can transfer in the system, right? So suppose the system absorbs heat Q isothermally and reversibly at temperature T and expands from volume V1 to V2. As you can see that this is weightless piston. So when it will absorb heat, then what will happen? Volume will increase from V1 to V2. And it will expand, gas will expand. Here, isothermally means at constant temperature. Okay, and reversibly means this reaction is reversible. Now, formula of entropy is delta S system. That means entropy of the system is Q reversible divided by capital T. Here, T is the temperature and Q is the heat. Now system absorb heat, that means same amount of heat is lost by surrounding, right? Because system is absorbing heat from the surrounding, from the heat reservoir. So the same amount of heat is lost by surrounding. So here we will write the amount of heat which is lost by reservoir. So here we will write change in entropy of the reservoir. So here The entropy will be same, but here sign will be opposite. Okay, so here for system it is Q reversible by T, for the surrounding, or we can say for the heat reservoir, it is minus Q reversible by T. Now total change in entropy is delta S1 is equal to entropy of system plus change in entropy of the heat reservoir. It is equal to zero because these are same, sign is opposite, so it is equal to zero. Now what will happen when we compress the gas isothermally? What will happen when we compress the gas at constant temperature? Okay, so here if we will compress the gas, then volume will change from V2 to V1, right? Volume will decrease. So now heat will be given out by the system and absorbed by the reservoir. So if heat is given out by the system, that means sign will be negative. Okay, so here delta S of system is negative of Q reversible divided by T, and as now heat is absorbed by the surrounding, that means heat reservoir, so its sign is positive, Q reversible divided by capital T. Now if you will add these two, then it is also equal to zero. That means total change in entropy for the complete cycle is equal to zero. So for both the cases, entropy is equal to zero. So here we can say that entropy is a state function. So that's all for today, students. Now this is a homework. So note down your homework. I will discuss questions of previous lecture in a separate video. So you can see that. If you have any doubt or queries, you can ask me on my email ID. Thank you and have a nice day.